it's still worth buying a petrol or diesel car in 2021. We live in a period of change in which we are flooded with all kinds of information. Some of them are true and some of them are less true.
Well, let me take you back in time. We are in Switzerland, in a natural park, in a beautiful location where you can hear the birds, you can hear the animals, you can feel the smell, the fresh air, the fresh smell that you cannot feel it in a crowded city. And for this reason, because the auto industry, the factories and all that industry in the last years was grow so much, the government start to change the rules. Because of this reason, the big questions are, it is still worth buying a petrol or even a diesel car in 2021 and in the future? The plug-in hybrids are a good option for the future. The electric cars are the future. The petrol or diesel cars, it will still hold the value in time. All those questions I will try to answer you in this video.
As you probably know, most of the governments around the world are planning to ban petrol and diesel engine from 2030. And the reason for it being CO2 emission contribute to global warming, which eventually will lead to an environmental catastrophe. And as you probably know, the auto industry and the factories and other industry in the world, they help to grow the emission in the atmosphere. I'm not going to go into detail about this subject. Probably I will cover it in other video. The difference between petrol and diesel engine, I have to tell you from the start that the subject is very complex and I try to keep it short. Petrol engine will emit more greenhouse gases and other pollutants, which will lead to a higher CO2 emission, which finally will help increase global warming. On the other hand, diesel engine produce less CO2 because they burn less fuel, but they produce a higher concentration of other pollutant like nitrogen oxide and very tiny particles named PM2.5, and this lead to less air quality for people but better for the planet and global warming. Like, whatever you choose, it will be a bad choice, and that's why the world need a better solution for transportation and industry. From 1919, diesel car was adopted more and more, and since then, more cities report a higher increase in air pollution. In 2012, the World Health Organization declared that diesel exhaust are carcinogenic and also dangerous for the population. Several studies over the last years show that more cities, especially in South Europe, report pollution over the legal limit, and that leads to more disease for the people that live in the cities. Solution to the petrol and diesel engine exist, and they are here today. We all know that more and more electric cars are coming on the market today. Car manufacturers invest huge amount of money in electric technologies. Are electric motors the ultimate solution? Probably yes, but recently Porsche announced that they work on a synthetic fuel 100% clean of pollution that will allow performance model cars to run after the petrol and diesel engine will be banned. It is called synthetic methanol gasoline and will be produced using green hydrogen made with renewable energy. Another question that arrived with the ban is, would you still be able to drive your old petrol or diesel engine after 2030? The answer is simple, yes. The people will still be able to drive the old diesel cars and petrol cars, but probably not in the city. The point is, all the cars after 2030 will be electric or some kind of free of emissions. In terms of plug-in hybrid cars, they will be on sale until 2035. After that, they will probably have the same fate as the combustion engine cars. The governments around the world want to reduce the emission to zero until 2050. Is that a reason to worry about your IC car? Probably not if you are planning to hold it less than 15 years. Will the value of the IC car will decrease in the future? Totally yes, if they don't find a way to keep them running on some kind of free emission fuel. The conclusion in the end is that electric cars are a great option for the future, but for sure they have to improve the battery technology. Also, I hope you enjoyed the video. I hope you get some useful information. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to see the new video that come on the market. Until then, stay safe and see you soon in the next one. Bye guys.